Hey, such an amazing morning in church this morning. Pastor Craig Clark preaching such a word in season for us, and where we find ourselves on the back end of 2 years of chaos. I love that Aristotle made that quote in 2019, knowing what we're going into, that at the back end of chaos, there's always something new happening. And God is going to do a new thing. I really do believe it. And I want to encourage you right now to just write down. I've made some notes today that I'm going to have to go back and look at in the week, because there was so much there that God's spoken to me and challenged me on. And I want to just encourage you, wherever you find yourself at home, take a moment to write those down. And God's speaking to us here on campus. We're going to break them down for you in a second. But I know God's speaking to you too. Write those down. Meditate on them, as Craig says. Read over them. Spend some time. I think that word meditation is quite a big word. But just spend some time reading over those thoughts and leading into what God's saying to you. And actually just take a moment to figure out what God is saying to you. Also, our heart is connection, connection, connection. We want to connect with you, even though we may be distanced. I believe we can still be connected and unified and moving in the same direction. So whatever that looks like for you, please scan the QR code. It's on the bottom of the screen. And we'd love to connect with you, find out what God's doing in your heart. Praise and prayer. Go onto the website, click the cards. Let us know how we can pray with you, journey with you. And if you are one of those people that sows so generously into the life of Link Church, even though you may be far away, thank you. You're incredible. Please continue to do so. And we're grateful for every seed that is sown in this house that helps us take the message of the gospel forward. So thanks for sowing so generously into our story. Bridge and Ams, great to have you guys with me on the wrap today.
So good thanks, to be Dad. Here.
There's so much going on there. We don't have too much time, to be honest. We're only about 5 minutes. So
it's okay.
We're going to have to be brief, but we can. I know there is gold.
You've done more with less time before.
there was so much gold.
What a word.
In there. Bridge, maybe you can start. Yep. You're on. You're all good there. Yep.
Okay. Am I on? Shucks. That was just such a powerful preach. I feel like I took so much away from that, and God's presence was so thick in the room.
It was evidence, yeah.
Yeah, really felt.
When you were speaking about two types of filled now at the end of the service.
Yeah, so good.
I don't know if you experienced it online, if you could feel it, but it felt like the auditorium was jam-packed full of the presence of God.
Yeah, I love that new thought of soaking him in as opposed to just being filled, you know.
Yep.
Yeah, so but I think for me, something that really stood out was the new positioning that God is, in order to do a new thing, he's repositioning.
Yes.
And you might find, you know, like they had to follow... they followed the cloud and the fire, but he repositioned them in a new land, and he did something completely new in them.
Yes.
And it's just such a powerful picture. It just spoke to me. It was beautiful. And so where will you find yourself? Where is God positioning you right now to bring the gospel, to speak into people's lives, to bring change and transformation, and to share God's courage with people around you?
Come on.
I love that, the practical nature of the examples he used, saying we find ourselves in this moment, and how it's actually found in God, not in a place.
So good.
So where are we positioning ourselves, whether it be in education, whether it be in politics, whether it be in business, wherever you find yourself now, actually position yourself there and make a difference.
Yeah, so good.
I love how he did like the whole perceiving, receiving the new, and then how will you give yourself to it?
Brilliant.
Yes. Like I think, so good.
I love the whole kind of like there's a posture to perceiving and to receiving.
Yeah.
Like God is across the planet doing a new thing, and you can feel there's a rumbling and a shaking in the foundations of things, and shaking things, everything that can be shaken. We've all felt it, but there is renewal on the other side of that, and there is something God is doing, but there is a position in a way that we receive and perceive the things that God is doing, the mantle. I think words he said to those that would let it settle upon them, which is really beautiful. Wow. When you think about the main distraction and the main temptation of the enemy right now, and for those that will let the mantle rest upon them, God will do and bring the new through. So I think that's beautiful.
Let the word of God and the presence of God settle on your life, and don't rush. Like I love that analogy also with the dinner time. It's an hour and a half in the 68 minutes now. I think sometimes we treat the word of God like a modern day dinner type meal, going, hey, I've only got 5 minutes. I'm going to rush in, get what I can out of it and head out. Actually, and I know practically sometimes we don't have the time, but we need to be trying to create some space to let those moments actually settle on us as a people. And
I love like Craig said, God doesn't just give us life, he is life.
Correct.
And like all over the Bible, Deuteronomy, Exodus, God speaks about himself being a jealous God.
Yeah.
Like, he doesn't just want all of, like, some of us. He wants all of us.
Doesn't want to be a patch.
And it's the whole practice of the presence of God. It's not about just being mindfully aware or reading a verse when you can or doing Bible study. It's literally a consuming fire.
Yeah.
And that's what God wants for our lives, is his presence.
Yeah,
being
so good.
Filled and soaked. Loved
even that whole thing of what he said about committing yourself to the mundane of every day. You know, the everyday tasks, would you do them with glory to God? And absolutely. In a way, like, yeah, exactly like you say, sitting around a table, sometimes it's like, okay, come guys, eat quickly.
Come, we gotta go.
Got homework and bedtime and you know, but actually would we just sit and allow God's presence to minister to us and work together.
So quick thought, we were just at a kind of conference type thing in Potchefstroom, but Francis Chan spoke there and he spoke about communion. And I was like, when he started, I was like, okay, communion. And it honestly just wrecked us. Like, so basically he spoke about, like, Acts 2, it speaks about how they dedicated, meaning they gave themselves to the reading of the word, the breaking of bread, the fellowship. And he said, we dedicate ourselves to the word and the church, but how much do we give ourselves to fellowship and to the breaking of the bread and the centrality and sacredness of communion? Like, for the first 1500 years of church history, they didn't believe this was a symbol. They believed it was the actual power and presence of God.
Wow.
And it was so beautiful as we watched literally a room of 150 pastors on their faces repenting before God for what they had done in displacing the centrality of this meal of communion, of relationship. And that's literally what this is. It's literally the invitation. That's the new thing that God's doing. We're believing is bringing this back to the centrality, his presence, his body, who he is.
Awesome.
I'll never see communion in a different light.
That's
an amazing thought, that.
Yeah.
And I know the church having communion right now. I'm not sure if you're prepared for it. You have cups of bread at home.
So good.
My communion cup is on my seat in the auditorium. Didn't make it out. But take a moment today, if you have family around you, to break some bread, share some wine. And that's not just a symbol. It's the power and presence of God. So very, very cool. Thought I loved was the prophetic people can help take people into the future.
Yes.
And some people see it and some people talk about it, but not many people actually get the opportunity to go there. And we can only go there by following the presence. I know you've touched on that already. And how they followed the cloud and the fire by day and by night and crossed the river and had to come out and follow a box. And sometimes I think following the presence of God might be like following a box, but we actually just have to press in, lean in, keep moving forward, lean into the presence of God, and let's help take the world that we influence into a greater future. Because I know we can see it and I know we can sense it. Do we have the courage to actually take people across there? So take them to it. All right, what are we taking into Monday?
Sure. Ems, do you want to go?
I've
got so much.
So I think, what I really loved about that message and what Craig said the most was not just to speak prophecy, but to be prophecy.
Yeah.
I think that was beautiful and powerful. And I've always been, well, recently been on this journey of just pursuing God's presence and just, just the 2 years. Like, his presence changes things. It fills rooms. It breaks chains. It brushes in new things. But I think there's also something to positioning yourself again. It's the positioning to receive and to perceive the new thing that God's doing, the mantle, the authority, the anointing of a spirit.
Beautiful.
And then to take that presence out, to not just speak prophecy, to not just post a post, but to actually live the prophecy, to live in a way as if you're seeing with your heart eyes. Like, our whole vision for the year is, what do you see when your eyes are closed and your heart's open? So it's not just speaking the words and putting out an encouraging post, but to actually live like that is our reality. Like,
so
Bill
good.
Johnson says, we don't. Our reality is heaven. We pull down heaven to earth. We don't live from earth to heaven.
Yeah.
And I think that is living prophecy, is to live out the heaven inside
so good.
Of us. Awesome. And that is what I want to pursue in my week.
Gosh, that is massive. Let's pray.
With the Spirit of God. Help of the Lord.
Sheesh, Ames, that's amazing.
Yeah.
That's awesome. I want to just touch on that other thing he mentioned at the end about the gap. That was so good. Did I steal your...
but it's fine. You'll say it better than me anyway. Go for it.
No, I won't say it because I have something else. But
no, go.
Just the presence of God for me to pursue that in a big way, and to ask God to just reveal that to the people around me. I just had this thought that came to mind. I've got a beautiful fragrance, the oud fragrance from poetry.
I don't know how you say it.
But it's it's a poetry diffuser in my classroom, and every time, without fail, a class comes in, they say, "Oh, we love the smell of this classroom." And it's like my prayer is that when they walk into my classroom, that they would sense God's presence.
So good.
Like they do that fragrance. Mm. That so they would good. Sense a difference, you know, that there'd be something different. Mm. And yeah, so that cool. I could like share that God's presence in me with them.
That's awesome. 2 yeah. Corinthians says we are the fragrance of Christ.
Ah,
there we go.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
You are the fragrance of Christ.
Yes, you are, Bridge.
And the fragrance of doves.
Come on.
Come on, somebody. All righty.
PG.
There's always a gap between our current reality and God's plan for us. I love that. Yeah. And in a temporary world, would we give ourselves to sticking around? I don't want this just to be a flash in the pan. I want to be here for the long haul. I want to put my feet on solid ground. I want to walk into a great inheritance. I want to see and feel a prophetic future and help take as many people there as we can. It's not going to happen in a week, but it's going to start this week.
Rome wasn't built in a day.
So,
hey?
No.
Anything significant.
And I love that. I love that thing. It's build houses, find land, build houses, have kids, let them have kids, plant orchards, eat from the orchards. I love the fact that it's a generational, long process. Yeah. It's not a quick fix. And if we can just keep showing up in our good days and our bad days, in the good weeks and the bad weeks, in the good times and the bad times, I believe God's going to, on the back end of all of that, we're going to see God do amazing things as a community.
Let's go.
Come on. I'm in. Thank you guys. It's been a great morning in church. We only got about 20 seconds left. So thank you so much for joining us this morning in church. And it's been an absolute cracker. We trust that God has spoken to you in some way. We'd love to hear about it. Please make sure you're connecting with us with the QR code below. Have an amazing week, and we'll catch you next week. Ciao, ciao.